Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. So let's continue with our topic, Lathe Machine. In last video, we have studied about headstock assembly and also we have seen the animation of chuck. So in this video, we will study about carriage assembly. So let's begin. The carriage of lathe machine is located between headstock and tailstock. The basic function of carriage is to support, guide and feed the tool against the job during operation. The carriage assembly of lathe consists of number of components that supports, move and controls the tool. The carriage assembly consists of tool post, compound rest, saddle, apron, power feed clutch, carriage hand wheel, cross slide hand wheel and cross slide. Let's study all these components in detail. Of carriage. Major parts of carriage such as lever, gears, clutch, automatic feed, split nut is provided in apron. It is useful in providing power and hand feed to both carriage and cross slide. It is also used to provide power feed to carriage during thread cutting through half nuts. The second component is power feed clutch. Power feed clutch is located between the feed rod and apron drive train. It is only used when feeding using the feed rod to power either the carriage feed or cross slide. It is not used for threading operations. For threading, half nut lever is used. The saddle is H-shaped casting supported over a bed base and slides on the bed. The saddle supports the cross slide, compound rest and tool post. The saddle can move along the ways either manually or by power feed. It can be locked at any position to carry out facing operations. The next component is tool post. Tool post is mounted on compound rest and provides a means of holding the cutting tool. The main function of tool post is to hold and adjust the tool at convenient working position. Manual lathe machines may have a variety of tool post. A quick change tool post like the one shown in the figure is convenient way to change the tools. There are different tool posts used in lathe machines that are single screw tool post, four bolt tool post, open slide tool post and square turn tool post or four-way tool post. The next component of carriage assembly is cross slide and cross slide hand wheel. Cross slide is mounted on top of the saddle. The tool can be moved at right angle to lathe axis by rotation of the wheel of cross slide. The graduation are provided on hand wheel to give correct amount of feed. Compound rest and tool post are mounted on cross slide. It can be moved by hand wheel or power feed. Although power feed is usually available to the cross slide, it is often convenient to position the tool manually. The cross slide hand wheel is provided for this purpose. Turning this hand wheel moves the cross slide in radial direction with respect to workpiece and will result in diameter change. The next component of carriage assembly is compound rest and compound rest hand wheel. Compound rest is also known as compound slide. It is mounted on cross slide. The purpose of compound rest is to support the tour post. The base of compound rest is circular and provides with graduation 45 degree on both sides. The compound rest can be swinged to desired angle for moving the tool in desired angular direction. It does not have any power feed, that's why hand wheel is provided. It is used to make tapered cut. Tapers are conical features that cannot be cut on manual machine by using orthogonal motion of carriage and cross slide. In general, CNC lathe machines do not have a compound rest because taper motion is achievable under computer control by moving the carriage and cross slide simultaneously. Most lathe machines do not have a power feed available to the compound rest. The angle of compound rest is adjusted by loosening two or more blinding screws and rotating the compound.